And the last thing I learned is related to a very common question I was asked on my tours. Do you think things are getting better or worse? Do you think we are in the end of times? Do you see a Christian revival coming? You know, it's hard not to think that things could be getting better because you see men like me turning to the faith, or Kanye West, or many other high profile people. You see churches, at least in the Orthodox Church, are growing, especially the Antiochian Church. I talked to a priest there in Salt Lake. He said his parish is really growing. They have to build churches. The monastery, the Holy Cross Monastery in Wayne, West Virginia, they are building a huge church. So you see this, like, whoa, the faith is growing. Things are getting better. People don't want to be a consumer cog. They don't want to just use pleasures to get them through the day and just be addicted to stuff and this hyper materialism that we have in the USA. Things are getting better. You can say that. But at the same time, you can say that things are getting more worse than they ever have. Things are getting worse and worse every day, more and more evil every day. The average age that they're subjecting children to be trannified is getting younger and younger. First it was 9 years old, then 8. Now we're getting down to 5 years old. You see the drag queen story time is turning into drag queen stripper time. If you've seen that, now they're doing dances and taking off their clothes, which are funded by local taxpayers. So you're seeing some gay pride every June is getting more and more outrageous. I don't want to know what next June is going to be like. And so how can you reconcile this? How can you reconcile that things are getting better and worse at the same time? And we have to go to the Bible. Matthew 3:12, which talks about the wheat and the chaff, or chaff. So what it is that the farmer's land was infected with the weeds. And what is the farmer going to do? Now his whole crop could be ruined. And then the farmer said, no, we'll just let the weeds grow alongside the wheat. And then after the wheat has grown, we will harvest everything and then separate them. Separate the wheat from the chaff. The chaff will be thrown into where? Unquenchable fire. So this is what I see. I see, to me, that says good and evil are growing at the same time. And the higher good gets, the higher evil gets. The stronger your faith gets, the more determined people in their rebellion against God get. So this is what I see. And we can say, wow, that's kind of bad in some way. But, you know, would you have come to the faith, or I don't know where you are, maybe you're more sympathetic than you were a couple of years ago. Would you be more sympathetic if you didn't see all this evil around you? So this evil is serving a purpose. God uses evil for good. So the way it's going to be is that, yes, things are getting better, but at the same time, it's going to get worse too. But you're going to have the faith to get you through it. So the way I see it, if this is really going on, if a revival is going on, if more people are finding the faith, that means Satan is going to double his efforts. Satan is going to panic, and through his pride, is just going to try to bring the world down even worse. But this is so, personally, I don't look for signs in the culture, in the mainstream, to tell me where my faith should be. If I'm the only Christian man that is left and everyone is gay, everyone is sodomizing everyone, I don't care. That doesn't mean that I should do it. So don't take it as a sign that, oh, more people are growing in faith, so I should do that too. You know, don't be a follower of the herd, just be a follower of Christ. Don't worry about what other people are doing. This is one common strain I see in people. They're a little bit overly concerned about where things are going and what the future holds, if Christianity is going to grow. Don't worry about it. You don't need to worry. Just worry about your salvation today. If you are on the right path, if God has put you on the right path, if he's given you the gift of grace, then you can start to worry about the salvation of people close to you. You can serve a Christ-like example to your family and to your friends, not to browbeat them down, of course, not to say you got to go to church and on and on. So then you can start to be an example to other people. If you want to share the truth online, you can do so, and on and on. But really, don't worry about, you know, if the world is getting better, if the world is getting worse. I mean, it's both are going on at the same time. But just worry about you and your salvation, the choices that you make every day. So that's how I see it. You know, I don't want to be a part of a trend. If we're in a trend, that's fine. But I don't look towards trends to dictate how I live. You know, don't look at trends. Jesus is not a trend. You know, if it becomes a trend in a way that helps some people, that's fine. I don't care. If everyone wants to wear a Jesus shirt, I don't care. But the true faith is tough. The true faith is a struggle every day to fight against your passions, against the vices that you have. It should be difficult. It shouldn't be this happy Joel Osteen type of, you know, everything is great, no talk about hell, no talk about the punishments you will face if you don't bear fruits in this life. So that's what I say. Get ready for evil to grow at the same time good grows. But if you have your faith, if you're strong in God, I believe that you'll be able to make it through. Because I can tell you what, if you don't have God, there is no way you're going to make it through the evil times that are coming. It's going to go up. What are you going to do? What are you going to do when the world gets more degraded month after month, when the gays are basically banging on your door to sodomize you? What are you going to do? And without God in your life, I just don't see how you can make it through. So wherever you go, whether you're in the city or in the country, you're going to need God. And, you know, if you turn to God because a guy online did, if Kanye West did, then so be it. But it's going to be a long road. And don't worry about what other people are doing. Just focus on your faith and you will get there.